Good morning, Televiewers, and welcome to this other edition of The Brief, the very first for the week on My Media Prime Television. On today's edition of the program, we are bringing to you, as usual, some of the major headlines that the papers in Cameroon do carry today. And of course, as you know, over the weekend that was last Saturday, the very first Anglophone Prime Minister, the Right Honorable Simon Achidi Achu, was laid to rest at his native village in Santa Subdivision, Mezan Division of the Northwest Region of Cameroon. We shall equally talk about COVID gate and the audit, which of course some newspapers are taking keen interest in. Thank you so much for joining. Audrey Zaksa is around with me this morning, as usual, for us to dig several layers beneath the striking headlines the papers got for us this morning. Bonjour, Audrey.
Bonjour à toi, Lasha Kingsley, et bon lundi à toi et à vous, fidèles téléspectateurs. Très heureuse de vous retrouver ce matin. Et le journal Capitaux Publics, Cameroun Tribune, par lequel nous débutons ce matin, parle à sa grande une, n'est-ce pas, de la grâce présidentielle, ou alors la grâce présidentielle de 23 militants de sa formation politique, le RDPC, qui avait été sanctionné le 9 septembre 2020 par la commission de discipline ad hoc relativement aux élections municipales du 9 février de la même année. Cet acte de clémence publié le 24 juin 2021 par le président de la République, son Excellence Paul Biya. De cette formation politique est la résultante des demandes de grâce formulées par Jean-Marie Abouna, maire de Yaoundé Premier, Jean-Jacques Lengue-Malapa, maire de Douala Premier, Martin Savom, maire de la commune de Bibé dans la Haute-Sanaga, et 20 autres de leurs camarades. C'est ce qu'on apprend dans la grande une de Cameroun Tribune en kiosque ce matin. Le journal Le Feu Puisse Njawe, le messager pour sa part, s'intéresse ce matin à la manifestation de samedi dernier organisée par certains Camerounais de la diaspora se revendiquant proche de l'opposant Maurice Kamto. Selon notre confrère, cette manifestation a été initiée pour dénoncer la mal-gouvernance au Cameroun, notamment les malversations présumées autour de la gestion des fonds COVID-19 et des fonds de la CAN 2021. Poursuivons avec le jour de Aman Mana. Le journal bleu parle des nouveaux passeports. Vous le savez, justement, la procédure d'établissement du passeport biométrique a effectivement débuté le 1er juillet au Cameroun dans les représentants diplomatique. Voilà, donc le journal, ou alors nos confrères de Le Jour, ont mené une enquête et proposent tout ce qu'il faut pour tout ce qu'il faut savoir par rapport concernant ces passeports-là. C'est dans la page 5 que vous retrouverez plus de détails à ce sujet. Terminons donc avec le Tri-Hebdo Le Soir, qui parle de construction du centre hospitalier de Maroua. Les travaux piétinent, d'après le journal. Le constat du MinSanté en inspection sur le site du chantier du CHR de Maroua, perturbé par l'état de fait. Je ne veux pas d'un hôpital au rabais ici, de toutes les manières je ne l'accepterai pas, de même que nous ne sommes plus disposés à vous accorder une autre prorogation de délai, a déclaré tout député le ministre de la Santé publique à l'adresse du représentant de la société Alliance Construction. C'est dans la page 3 que vous aurez ample information à ce sujet. Voilà, mesdames, messieurs, pour les tabloïds en français. Place à toi en anglais, Lasha Kingsley.
Thank you, Audrey Zaksa. Let's kick starts with the Post newspaper. The Post this morning, like I did mention, is interested in the last homage or final journey to eternity of Achidi Achu. According to the paper, Achidi Achu gets farewell from thousands amid tight security in Santa Subdivision, Northwest region of the country. He was decorated by the Prime Minister of the Republic of Cameroon, representing the President of the Republic. And the paper goes over to say the laying to rest of the late Right Honorable Simon Achidi Achu in his native Santa village was witnessed by thousands of people from within and without the country, who came to pay him last respects. We are told that our last respect abet the very heavy presence of the military in that part of the country. The former PM passed on to glory on May 4, 2021 in the United States of America after a protracted illness. PM Chief Dr. Joseph Diongute, who was representing the President of the Republic, or in his twin capacity as the personal representative of the Head of State, Paul Biya, and also as Head of Government, decorated Simon Achidi Achu with the Medal of Grand Cordon of the Cameroonian Merit posthumously. You can get more details about how the funeral service or ceremony unfolded in Santa only in this edition of the Post newspaper. Let's talk about the new biometric passports in the country. The Delegate General for National Security delivers first biometric passports in 24 hours in a ceremony in Yaoundé. That was recently. Delegate General for National Security, Martin Bangangele, presented or handed over the first passport to the applicants in Yaoundé. Let's talk about COVID-gate. COVID-gate, where auditors condemn CFA 1 billion wasted on a hastily dismantled treatment center, the treatment centers which were mounted in some stadia across the national territory, were hastily dismantled according to the report. So the auditors blame this issue or the wastage of 1 billion francs CFA on the said facilities that were meant to treat those who were infected with the COVID-19 pandemic. Let's leave the Post newspaper. The Guardian Post is also interested in the first applicants receiving their biometric passports within 48 hours in the country. The Delegate General for National Security, Martin Bangangele, handed over the passports to the applicants in Yaoundé in a ceremony that was organized recently. Equally, Nation bids farewell to energetic politician Achidi Achu. Biya's wife hailed the former PM as a level-headed, astute politician or political icon. That was during a ceremony presided over by the Prime Minister of the Republic, Chief Dr. Joseph Diongute, in the northwest region of the country, precisely in his native village, Santa. Let's also talk about Kupe Mwaninguba Meme. Suspected Amber fighters killed GCE examiner and a Nigerian woman. You can get more details about the killing by suspected separatist fighters only in this edition of the Guardian Post. And the Chronicle Times this morning is interested in late Cardinal Ntumi. According to the paper, Cardinal Ntumi's last testimony. The last testimony, a conversational autobiography of Christian Cardinal Ntumi, has been released. The book, authored by Ellie Smith, senior journalist Ellie Smith, was released recently. You can get more details about the autobiography of His Eminence Christian Cardinal Ntumi of blessed memory, only in this edition of the Chronicle Times newspaper. The Chronicle Times also reports on the final journey to eternity of the former Prime Minister Simon Achidi Achu. The paper says former PM Achidi Achu goes home in Pom. More details in this edition of the paper. And we end with this headlines talking about GCE 2021. Over 17,000 students taking exams nationwide. The examination enters week two, a very crucial week this Monday. More details only in this edition of the Chronicle Times newspaper. Thank you for watching, televiewers. We are back in the studio with our guest. He is, of course, Sir Mutaga Sivanos Tifu, special advisor to Professor Maurice Kamto of the MRSC party. Good morning, sir, and you're welcome once again.
Good morning, Mr. Alasha Kingsley, and good morning to your co-host, Audrey Raza. Good morning to all the millions of televiewers of my Major Prime TV, especially those who love the program, The Brief. Good morning to all the Cameroonians in the diaspora, those who converged on Paris last 3 of July 2021 to express their discontentment against with regards to what is happening in Cameroon. Let's take the very first case, the COVID gate and the illegal imprisonment of many militants of the Cameroon Renaissance Movement and other political parties like the CPP, because remember last 22nd of September 2020, militants of these political parties went in the street saying the elections that were supposed to be held, that's where the municipal and parliamentary elections were not supposed to be held, why the war in the northwest and the southwest region is going on, and why the consensual reform of the electoral system has not been done.
Du professeur Maurice Kamto, le président de le mouvement pour la résistance du Cameroun à Paris. Pourquoi avoir choisi tout d'abord Paris pour cette réunion?
Oui, le professeur Maurice Kamto a visité Paris, c'était en 2019. Pour cette année 2021, la manifestation qui a eu lieu le 3 juillet à Paris n'a pas été organisée par le mouvement pour la renaissance du Cameroun.
C'est la première chose. Supporters, probably.
Oui, c'est la première chose que nous devons clarifier à l'opinion nationale et internationale. C'était juste une manifestation organisée par la diaspora camerounaise qui est vraiment mécontente par rapport à toutes les dérives qui minent le gouvernement de notre
Donc,
pays.
Donc le professeur Maurice Kamto n'avait rien à voir
avec... Il n'avait rien à voir avec les manifestations de la diaspora. Il est bien vrai que... Il est bien vrai que dans notre formation politique... On peut laisser nos militants assister des fois donc des manifestations à titre civil, parce que je pense que la diaspora, comme les militants du MS qui sont à la diaspora, sont d'abord membres des associations de la diaspora. Je veux dire, ils sont d'abord d'office les membres des associations, je veux dire des sociétés civiles de la diaspora. Et comme je disais, ce n'était pas le MSC qui a organisé la marche, mais pour vous dire honnêtement, nous sommes au courant, que la, conscients du fait que la diaspora camerounaise aujourd'hui, que qu'en soit la diaspora camerounaise qui se trouve aux États-Unis, en Europe, en Asie, en Australie ou partout, ne joue que par le nom du professeur Maurice Kamto, en tant que de l'homme politique emblématique, charismatique, qui peut fédérer toutes les forces politiques de notre pays pour une éminente attenance dans notre pays.
Et justement, est-ce qu'on peut dire aujourd'hui que les meetings, ou alors tous les meetings qu'organise le professeur Maurice Kamto entraînent généralement des affrontements, de la haine et tout? Est-ce qu'on peut dire ça?
Je réitère ici, les meetings organisés par le professeur Maurice Kamto n'entraînent jamais l'affrontement, parce qu'il faut comprendre d'abord, le slogan du mouvement pour la renaissance du Cameroun est « Changeons l'avenir dans la paix ». C'est-à-dire, nous pensons que pour changer un système gouvernemental comme le système qui règne au Cameroun depuis 39 ans, il faut d'abord passer par les urnes. Voilà pourquoi nous prenons, nos avocats, je pense que le collectif, même les autres partis de l'opposition se sont réunis avec le MSC pour qu'il y ait une réforme consensuelle du système électoral. Je reviens de ce qui cause l'affrontement suivant quand il y a les manifestations. Vous savez, le régime en place qui est prédominant, le régime RDPC et ses alliés, ils ont des usines de fabrication des choses horribles et inimaginables. Des moments, qu'est-ce qu'ils font comme ça? Parce que quand vous êtes un leader de l'opposition très redoutable comme le professeur Maurice Kamto et un parti politique avec les militants très fidèles qui croient à l'idéologie du parti et qui... C'est pour comme une religion.
Many have accused a party of being too aggressive. You are taking on an aggressive approach.
Oui, je reviens à vous. Pour déstabiliser le MLC et faire à ce que les gens haïssent le MLC, il faut utiliser d'autres moyens pour dire le MLC est un parti agressif ou de ceci-là. On connaît. Vous vous souvenez que lors du meeting de 2019 à Paris et au Canada et aux États-Unis, le régime en place avait déguisé ses militants habillés dans les tenues ambazoniennes pour venir tenter le professeur Maurice Kamto et le mettre à l'épreuve pour que si Maurice Kamto l'acceptait pour les embrasser. On allait dire que non, c'est lui qui sponsorise les ambazoniennes. Pourtant, on le sait très bien que c'est un homme.
We'll come back to the activities of your party. Let's go to Bamenda. Now let's talk about the final journey to eternity of the former prime minister Simon Achidi Achu. He was buried in his native village Santa on Saturday, and the ceremony was attended by, you know, a cross section of the political class, traditional rulers, you know, mourners coming from everywhere.
The man Achidi Achu is a political icon that I respect so much, and I think that
but your president was not there. Your president of your party, no representative of your party, apparently.
Yeah, just like President Paul Biya was not there. So, like I was saying,
no, he was represented there.
Surely, maybe our militants were represented there. So we cannot go into that. So, like I was saying, that's the late fallen hero, late Prime Minister Chidi Achu, is somebody that I respect so well because of his political career. I want to say that he's one of those people that believe that politics should be done in a way that it should be aspiring to better the conditions of the ordinary citizens and everyone. That's why he came up with the slogan, Politik Nanjangi.
Yes.
Means that when people vote you to parliament, when they vote you maybe to the municipal, that's to the council, they expect that you should come up with projects that would be worth enough to better their living conditions. So if you look at the man Achidi Achu, you find that he was a seasoned politician. He came to power on the 29th of October 1971, and from 29th of October 1971 right up to 3rd July 1972, he was the minister of inspection of the state minister in charge of inspection. Mm-hmm. So you find that on July 3rd 1972 to 30th June 1975, he became the minister of justice and keeper of the seals. And then from 9th of April 1992 right up to 19th of September 1996, he was now appointed by President Paul Biya as the Prime Minister. So when he died in the United States of America, there was a rumor, popular rumor, especially those of us usually consult the social media. We were even told that he was buried in the United States of America. So many of us said, no, Prime Minister Achidi Achu, who is a traditional ruler in the Northwest region, cannot violate the customs and traditions of the Northwest region and be buried in a foreign land. It would be like a kind of desecrating the culture of the Northwest region. So I want to think that the family did well, the state of Cameroon did well to have repatriated his corpse back from the United States of America to bury in Santa. But one thing that is still bothering us, if a man of his caliber could die in the United States and the corpse is brought back, what more of the corpse of former president of the Republic of Ahidjo, of Cameroon, I mean, that, President Ahmadou Ahidjo? We have been expecting
discussion for some
that
other day.
That should be done.
Yeah, okay, we are expecting that should be done. And we equally have some other newspapers talking about the Bamenda Babaju stretch of road, calling on the elites and the government of Cameroon to collaborate, the elites of the Northwest region to collaborate so that the route can be realized. It should be recalled that recently the government of Cameroon secured loans from the World Bank and African Development Bank for the construction of the Babaju Bamenda stretch of road and the Bamenda Ring Road.
Mr. Lasha Kingsley, I can no longer continue to sell out the bleak assertion that the road Babaju Bamenda has not been constructed because of the Amber Fighters. I don't think the Amber Fighters have been in any way against the construction of that stretch of road.
Did you go to Bamenda?
The last time I visited Bamenda, I think it dates back to the month of May, and we're just in July. It's not long. And that stretch of road, I think, is quite deplorable. And we know that a lot has been donated for the construction of that stretch of road. I want to say that the Minister of Public Works and even other partners that are supposed to engage or to be committed in the construction of that stretch of road, they are just using the pretext of the war going on in the Northwest and Southwest region to siphon the money. So I think thorough investigation has to be done. And these guys, if for over 5 years that road has not been constructed, the companies that have been awarded that contract, the Minister of Public Works, and all other persons constituted that are supposed to be part of seeing that the road is constructed, I think it's high time they be called to order, because we cannot continue talking of one and indivisible Cameroon, and we know for certain that what caused the crisis in the Northwest and Southwest region was due to the bad state of roads in the Northwest, the educational system that was almost being adulterated with the Francophone dissertation, which obviously I think a lot has been done, and the road still in that state in 2021, I think it is unheard of, it is diabolic, it is unacceptable, and then it's criminal for those who were supposed to ensure the construction of
Let's
that.
Let's rapidly end with this this issue about the new biometric passports in Cameroon. The first ones were delivered to the applicants in Yaoundé by the Delegate General for National Security, Martin Bangangele.
Un sujet qui a fait beaucoup de controverses. On a vu des Camerounais se plaindre du fait qu'on attend de voir, on attend finalement cela. Il y en a qui ont reçu leur passeport en 48 heures, effectivement.
Are you optimistic?
I just love Yaoundé. It's not up to 48 hours old. I wanted to have my own biometric passport, but unfortunately for me, my identity card, which I filed in to establish, is about 9 months today. I've not gotten it. That's the very first requirement for you to have the biometric passport for the 8 hours old.
And they didn't say biometric ID card.
That's the question. That's the very first thing they were supposed to do, because there is a document you need before going in for the biometric passport. We are talking of Cameroon, a country in which people who applied for the authentic national identity card is 3 years today. Some of them have not gotten it. I think an octogenarian like Bangangele being at the helm of an institution like that, which is so demanding, is something that is not very normal. What he has just done, it is a way, maybe it's a camouflage. Because
why should you say camouflage?
Mr. Lasha Kingsley,
an agreement was signed. A German company.
Honestly speaking, we don't take the second step before the first. There are a lot of complaints about the establishment of the national identity card. We expected Bangangele, if he says he's a technocrat, he would have done everything possible
to
remedy that situation.
Why some of these people whose ID cards are not being delivered, reasons why they are not being delivered? Some of them have two birth certificates, double fingerprints, double entries.
The very first thing we should understand.
Comme il y en a également qui n'ont aucun problème.
One thing I want to say is, you said they have a double birth certificate. We have double fingerprints. I don't think that it can be double fingerprints.
Sorry, I'm talking about the double ID card, different dates of birth, and then when it gets
it is not a problem. It's not a problem. Take for example, if you were an accountant.
Yes.
And you suddenly change profession, maybe into the you become a soldier. I don't think it's a problem because you change profession to another profession that your ID card cannot come out.
Change your date of birth.
So we are talking now. I think that the stations in which they introduce files, names, information into the machine, the very first thing is it's supposed to be well computerized in such a way that if you arrive there, before your information is entered into the machine, they will tell you, gentlemen, you had entered with this particular name in this year. It is impossible for us to enter your name again the second time. Go back and get the other information, because it is it. So I want to tell you that it is dupery, because if they collect 2,800 francs from Cameroonians, sometimes it goes right up to 5,000 francs, sometimes even 20,000 francs just to have the cartoon. And they tell you they are unable to issue your identity card because you have multiple identifications, entries, which you did. I want to tell you that it is unheard of in this very present dispensation, 21st century. Everything is computerized. Let me take an example. Go to the Minister of Finance in Yaoundé. I want to tell you, we are talking of Cameroon. There are people there at the Minister of Finance in Yaoundé who go for missions 3,000 days. A year, whereas we are talking of 365 days per month. Let me tell you, that's the question you tell me, like Mr. Bia asked Eric Chinde, do you have any proof of what you are saying? I'm calling the those in charge to go and do their investigation. Let them investigate. Then they investigate into what is happening in all, I'm not sure it's only the Minister of Finance. That's what's happening in all the ministries. People go on mission 3,000 days per year, whereas we have 360 and one quarter days in here.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of the program today. Thank you so much for coming. It's always a pleasure having you.
Thank you, Mr. Lasha Kingsley. Always very honored whenever you invite me to talk to Cameroonians, and especially to share on very pertinent issues that are concern our country.
Thank you for watching, televiewers. The program was produced by Christian Tebon. For presentation, we've been Audrey Zaxa and myself, Lasha Kingsley. See you tomorrow for yet another edition of What the Papers Must Have Said. Bye-bye.